In my last video, where I showcased my attempt on switching to Linux, I tried installing Affinity and failed. But now I finally found a quite easy way to install the Affinity apps, so I want to share it with you. I will quickly go over what performance you can expect, which of course might differ a lot, but from what I was reading, I got a pretty average experience. Feature-wise, pretty much everything works, even the studio link on Publisher. A few things that didn't work for me were the liquify persona in Photo, because it would crash my window manager and I was forced to log out. And for some obscure reason, the stock window where you can access stock photos from Pexis and Pixabay didn't show up. I thought maybe some network settings weren't configured, but I was able to download and install the AI models for the object selection, so yeah, really weird. But you can just copy and paste images from your browser or files, so it's okay. Another weird issue was that when doing vector, the paths didn't resemble what was going to render, which sadly is very limiting when doing vector. Also, I couldn't get hardware acceleration to run, which apparently is to be expected. This made some features awfully slow to render, but most of the time it still felt responsive enough. I also sometimes had crashes when I was zoomed in pretty close to the canvas. You might also get issues with flickering, but I could fix it when sticking to X11 and by making sure to enable all graphics features in Lutris. Saving and export features work just fine, and opening recent projects also worked. When you do encounter saving issues, make sure to select Save As instead. I will use the guide from Trick6943 in this video, as it was the only one which worked for me. But you can tell it was updated a couple of times, so there are some inconsistencies throughout the guide. I'm on EndeavourOS, since the project works better on modern distros. First, we will need to download Wine TKG Affinity, which is a special fork of Wine. You will see the files are labeled Arch build and Fedora build, but that only refers to the distro they have been built on. So according to the documentation, you should be able to use it on every distro. I will choose the Arch build file here. Now you will also need to install Lutris, either from Flatpak or an app image. Flatpak is recommended, but I already had Lutris installed as an app image. We will now install Wine TKG Affinity as a runner for Lutris. Open two windows or tabs of your file explorer and navigate into one of those directories, depending on whether you've installed Lutris through Flatpak or an app image. In the other tab, extract the Wine TKG archive and copy the user folder from it. Now paste it into the Lutris directory and rename it to this. Download the Wine TKG Affinity install script from here and install it on Lutris by launching Lutris and clicking on the plus icon. Then choose Install from script, click the three dots and navigate to the downloaded script and hit install. This will probably take a while to finish. In the meantime, you can already download the Win metadata from the guide and download the Affinity installers. Make sure to download the msi/exe files from your Affinity license. After Lutris finishes the installation, you can close the window and you should now have a game in Lutris. Now extract the Win metadata zip and copy the folder from it. In your home directory, you should now see a folder called Affinity on Linux. Go into it, and then into the drive C directory, then into Windows, and then into System32. Now just paste the folder. Go back into Lutris and right-click on the game. Click Configure, navigate to Game Options, and from those three dots, navigate to one of the downloaded.exe files from Affinity. Hit Save and then click on Play. This should launch the Affinity installer, where you can just continue through it without custom adjustments. After it finishes, configure it again and choose the other .exe installers and play them until you have all Affinity applications installed. Now we will have to choose the executables for actually launching the apps. So configure the game again, and this time when choosing the executable, navigate into the Affinity on Linux folder again, into the drive C folder, into the program files, and then into the Affinity folder. From there, navigate into one of the apps folders and choose the according.exe file. For Affinity Photo, it's photo.exe, for Designer it's designer.exe, and for Publisher it's publisher.exe. After you chose one of them, go into the runner options and make sure all the graphics options are enabled. Then click Save. Now you can right click and duplicate the game and navigate to one of the other .exe files in your duplicates configuration. Simply repeat this until you have a game for all of the Affinity apps. Then you can select one of the games, click play, and it should run. If you run into issues when starting the Affinity apps, it might help to update your system and to reboot. Also, if your launch Publisher and Studio Link isn't working, make sure to go into your account in Publisher and to log in. After that, it should work. If you have further tips for a successful Affinity installation or were able to fix a few issues, it would be cool if you would leave them in the comments so others can benefit from it. You can also configure custom artworks for the games in Lutris to make them look nicer. I created some by screenshotting the startup screens of the different apps and then inpainting additional text elements I didn't need. So yeah, that's all. Bye!